Revive me. Spank us if she'd see us doing it, but you could hide behind the book or whatever. You know, if it's in your heart, they'll get out. They were behind 7-0, I believe, and in one inning, they filled the bases, and if I remember right, Bob Gibson hit a home run. They went on to get 10 runs in that inning and win the game. I said to God, can you beat that? It was so exhilarating, thrilling. I gave my heart to the Lord that fall. I was in Mason, Illinois at a Holiness rally on a Sunday afternoon. Played my trombone on the front seat. It was a packed house and sat on the seat for the message. Brother Sutherland, that young evangelist, the conference president, was shelling the woods. God came on him and came on all of us. I sat there on that front seat and wept like a baby. Praising God every time Brother Sutherland landed a blow. And it was like God said to me, doesn't this beat that? I tell you what, it beat it so much for the last 30 years and more. It'll be 33 years this fall. I've been singing, Christ is not a disappointment. Every longing in my breast. He really completely satisfies. If you're wrestling with the world, whatever sin is, I want to challenge you this afternoon. You let go and let God have His way, and He'll more than satisfy you. Praise His wonderful name.
Christ alone has met my longing. Though it promised much, it failed me. All its wells and springs were dry. Everything I tried was empty. Then I thought that life was vain. But He came and took my heartstrings, and I learned to sing again. Christ.
Let's all stand for just a moment here. Amen. One of our precious brothers have come to the altar during that wonderful song. With our heads bowed for just a moment, is there anybody else that maybe the Spirit is leading you or urging you to seek the help of God? I certainly want to be conscious of the move of the Spirit, and we don't want to do anything that would in any way keep the Spirit from having His perfect liberty.
Stretched downward, just one touch, and then a new life began. And the old rugged cross made the difference in a life bound for heartache and defeat. And I will praise Him forever and ever, for the cross made the difference for me. Barren walls echoed harshness and anger. Little feet ran in terror to hide. But now those walls ring with love, warmth, and laughter, since this giver of life moved inside. Now there's a room filled with sad ashen faces. Without hope, death has wrapped them in gloom. But at the side of the saints there's rejoicing, for life, it can be sealed in a tomb. And the old rugged cross, it made the difference in a life bound for heartache and defeat. And I will praise Him forever and ever, for the cross made the difference for me. And I will praise Him forever and ever, for the cross made the difference for me.
Amen.
God's children, 40 years He led them through the cold and through the night. Though they said, "Let's turn back," Moses said, "Keep going, Canaan land is just inside. There will be no sorrow. By and by, milk and honey flowing, there is where I'm going. Canaan land is just inside. Though we walk through valleys, though we climb high mountains, we must not give up the fight. We must be like Moses. We must keep on going inside. There will be no sorrow there in that tomorrow. We will be there by and by.
The cross upon which Jesus died is a shelter in which we can hide, and its grace so free is sufficient for me, and deep is its fountain as wide as the sea. There's room at the cross for you. There's room at the cross for you. Though millions have come, there's still room for one. Yes, there's room at the cross for you. Though millions have found him a friend and have turned from the sins they have sinned, the Savior still waits to open the gate and to welcome a sinner before it's too late. There's room at the cross for you. There's room at the cross for you. Though millions have come, there's still room for one. Yes, there's room at the cross for you. And don't turn him away. Don't turn him away. He has come back to your heart again. Although astray, oh, how you'll meet him to plead your cause on that eternal day. Don't turn the Savior away from
just what you need.
a comfort. He'll be your friend. He'll be your help in time of trouble. If you're bound, He'll set you free. He'll be to you what you need Him to be. Yes, there's room at the cross for you. Praise God.
could still say, I forgive. There's only one way to define it. There's no other way to say it. There's only one way to describe it. It's called love.
I cannot see.
Your majesty's house inside. down from His glory, ever-living story, my God and Savior came, and Jesus was His name, born in a to His own a stranger, a man of sorrows, tears, and agony. Oh, how I love Him, how I adore Him, my brother, my sunshine, my all in all, the great Creator became my Savior, and all God's fullness dwelleth in Him. What condescension, bringing us redemption, that in the still of night, not one faint hope in sight. God gracious, laid aside His splendor, stooping to woo, to win, to save my soul. Oh, how I love Him, how sunshine, my all in all, the great Creator became my Savior, and all God's fullness dwelleth in Him. My heart is stirred whene'er I think of Jesus, that blessed name which sets the captive free. No name on earth has meant so much.